same patch where you were getting earlier the trend, this turnouts of each phase. On the same button, you will get the results of DDC election. At present, if I click, you will not get anything because we have not linked it. We'll be linking it screen. Like this. On the top, you will get a drop-down menu for select district. So normal option at present, default option is all districts, and then select constituency, default option is all constituencies. Now there are three types of reports which we are making available to you. First is the counting trends, which will be till any results are declared. So you will be getting counting trends round wise. As soon as a round is frozen, round is completed in a district and the data is frozen by the concerned district authorities, you will get the counting trends for that district, and then once one round is completed for all the districts, you will get it for entire UT also, which will be later on available. And then the third thing is party wise trends also we'll give you later on whenever this data gets populated in various sheets. Now if I say like if you choose the counting trends to begin with, and I keep the default option only all districts and all constituencies, it will give you the top two candidates of each DDC constituency. So the one who's leading and the one who is trailing, two candidates you will get in this consolidated list, which are under counting process, where the counting process is started. So like we have actually fed some dummy data here. So at present you have a list of these constituencies which is available. Now this is the consolidated list. If you want to see two candidates per constituency of the entire UT, and then if you are interested in a particular district, say Kupwada, and then all constituencies of Kupwada if you choose, then you will get so the Kupwada, I think no data is fed. I'll choose Baramati. So Baramulla, all constituencies, you will get the top two candidates. Okay, all 14 constituencies. So if all for the first round, then you will have all 14 into 228 candidates being displayed here. The first, leading one and the runner-up. Now if I want to know the a particular constituency, all candidates, like each candidate, even if he is trailing at the fifth place or seventh place, then I have to choose a particular constituency within a particular district, then again enter the verification code. So they'll get for the entire Boniar constituency, all the candidates, what is the number of votes which are polled in favor of those candidates, you will get the entire detail of a single constituency. So this way you can scroll any district and select any district, select any constituency, get the details of each and every candidate, and if you are interested in overall details of the district, you will get each constituency. Again for the UT, you will get 218 to 2, like when all the constituencies are having like counting is started, and you will have some data for each constituency, then you will have 218 to 2 candidates being displayed in the first option, default option. So it's the same thing. You have, if you want to know the final results, you will be clicking on final results. Same process has to be followed. Same party wise trend also you can find out. For example, for the same constituency, if I say, if I want to know this party wise trends, then you will get, this is the state of this Boniar. Like independent is having, like this is just a dummy data for demonstration purpose. So some figures like this will come in front of each party and the independents also.